Reposition here a little bit. I don't think there's any gun that's more suited to realism mode than sniper. Especially this thing. Just get a few haircuts this game. Alright. So because the glass is broken, I'm just gonna move in here. This is why it's fun to play as a sneaky sniper. Feels like you play one of the ghillie suit missions from COD 4. Did just hear people over this way. I think she must have been a solo. Literally heard nothing this whole time. So yeah, just assume that we're good. That was a pretty crazy opening. There's definitely... a fight going on here. It's a little bit brutal. It's completely gate crashed their fight. Sorry about that. Someone's still in that house. So that's going to be the teammate of the female character. And then there's still the teammate of the first guy that I got. Moving around here is... it's a bit risky, to be honest, because I'm potentially freeing up the first guy's revive. Kind of hoping that he won't know that it's safe. think that was the teammate. I want to go and check this body just to make sure it's not revived. Okay, I'm pretty sure it's a 1v1 here with the White House guy. I don't think anyone's been revived. I do need to try and keep it that way. He's pushing. He's trying to close the distance on me. I can't be having that, not with a sniper. I'm gonna run away. This is just gonna be a big range game, this, isn't it? I'm not actually sure what weapon he's got, but it's definitely going to beat me at close range. Most things will. Trying to use choke bombs a bit more aggressively. I think they can be pretty good at stopping people from pushing through. So he's pretty much outpositioned me here. He's pinned me in. I don't think he knows exactly where I am. Awesome. Like, I played really well. Really well. I don't know if they've picked it up. It's really hard to tell. Realism mode problems. Alright, let's reposition a bit. Cool. I feel like when you play without a HUD, you sort of... you kind of heighten the rest of your senses, right? So you've got increased awareness about your character and the map and how everything's playing out. I just feel like when you combine that with playing a sniper, playing like slowly, methodically, I don't know, there's just something really immersive about it. It's really cool. I think they've realized that they have to take the fight. Because I do have all the exits covered, so... what am I going to do here? So I'm going to get up in this tower. Even though it kind of seems like a bad position. Kind of in an open field, so this is the best way for me to get some range. Also... seeing me pinned up here, hopefully it gives him a bit of confidence to come and get me. I want to try and make sure they fight here and avoid me. It's a bit of a risky strategy, but... what we do. So they've actually done a pretty good job here. They've split up. Trying to surround me. So now, basically, I'm gonna fight on two fronts and keep him away. Because if they make it to the base of this tower, I'm in trouble. Like whack-a-mole. As soon as one makes a move, that's the one you've got to focus on and keep him at bay. That's a good shot. One. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I got him. I'm gonna have to move in here, I think. Yep. I'm gonna go and race this guy for the revive. You gotta make your advantage stick. Body. Oh. job done.